Hello, I am Chrissy with Cooking with Chrissy in the Loo. And yes, I am still in my church clothes. On this evening, I am making Cajun. I am making Cajun chicken Alfredo. Cajun chicken Alfredo. And I did the introductory video, but I have, I don't have the chicken breast, but this is chicken breast, but this is cut into tenders. So I'm going to season this right now. To make a Cajun, we're going to do, this is something new that I've never used before, is smoked paprika. Then we're going to do sea salt. And we got that in the grinder. We got black pepper. Black peppercorn in the grinder. We got Creole seasoning. And we're gonna season these babies up because I believe I got like the equivalent of, I got like the equivalent of two chicken breasts here. So I'm gonna pepper it. We got our noodles boiling over there. Turn that around on the stove. Noodles are boiling. I had a great time at church on this evening. I went to New Christ Temple. I went, of course, was at my church, Temple of Destiny. At first, I was real late because I really wasn't feeling like going to church, but I just had to press my way. I've been going through so much family stuff, you know. That's my boy, he got in trouble again. This is sea salt. I think I got this up too high. I don't be liking too much salt. So we got the sea salt. That sea salt bring out the flavor and stuff. And then we're gonna sprinkle some of this. This is my first time using this smoked paprika. I am very, curious to know how this is gonna taste and make stuff taste and stuff. Ooh, that's an interesting smell. Smell good. Smoked paprika. So I'm gonna sprinkle some of that on there. We're gonna get that pan hot and we're gonna use this 100% grape seed oil. It's gonna be my first time using it. I got a lot of first time ingredients here. I'm trying to expand my horizons as far as my seasonings. Put some of that Creole on there. We're gonna turn these babies over. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. I cannot wait to taste this, boy. I love me some good pasta. Pepper. Check on those noodles in a moment. But I had a blessed time. When I say I got there late, they were just, she was praying over people by the time I got there. Some mornings it just be like that. You can't hardly get started, boy. You be like, I'm not feeling it today. Put some Creole seasoning. Let me show y'all this Creole seasoning. We gonna make it Cajun. Smoked paprika. Put some onion powder, even though I got some onions over here, and I'm gonna show you guys just to save time. I already, you know, off camera, and of course, this chicken was washed and pat dry with a paper towel. So, there you go. That look good, don't it? Woo! We're gonna get to make sure that pan hot. This is some dry, they look like raisins, don't they? It's some dried, sun-dried tomatoes. This is my first time using this too, sun-dried tomatoes. We got minced, we got three minced garlic. I didn't mince it too small, but I don't want it to burn. Then I got the baby portobello mushrooms. I love these. They're so hearty. And then some onion, about half an onion. We're going to be cooking with half and half also. I'm going to get that out the fridge. Then we got white wine vinegar. We got Parmesan. We're going to top it off with that Parmesan at the end when we put that white wine and the... And this is actually three cheeses. It has Romano, Asiago, which really complements the sun-dried tomato. And we have Parmesan in here. As I kind of running low on that Parmesan, the shredded Parmesan. So I'm gonna put some of that in. That's just really to flavor it. Let me let y'all. Yep, that's really to like flavor it, you guys. You got my nameplate earrings, Crystal. I love these. This is my birthday month, y'all. It's May Day. It's May Day. And then me and the church, we're going to go down to a ball game down at the famous Busch Stadium on May 23rd. That is my birthday. I will be 50 and fabulous. You guys, please, 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 if you want to make my birthday great, continue to watch, like, share, and subscribe, like, share, and subscribe. Try these recipes. Engage with me. Let me know how, if you tried it, if you like it, what other recipes you would like to see. But please bless my Cash App, $CrystalThomas47, $Crystal spelled CrystalThomas, Thomas, Thomas, 47, $CrystalThomas47. And then I am Crystal Wagner 37 at yahoo.com for my Zelle. Crystal Wagner 37 at yahoo.com for my Zelle. If you would like to be a blessing for me for my birthday, my 50th birthday. I still don't know what I'm going to do because I'm very low on funds. I'm going to go over here. I'm going to take you guys with me and check on this noodle. Yeah, that would really make my 50th birthday if I could have my supporters, my followers be a blessing to me and bless my Cash App or my Zelle or both. I am not picky, you guys. I want you all to see that we're doing the rotini. It's about a pound of rotini noodles. Pound of rotini noodles, and I am going to get this pan ready. I need to set up over here. I'm gonna go ahead and set up over here. So you guys can see the process of me cooking this, putting together this, there we go. Putting together this Alfredo. We're gonna make this totally from scratch. This is my first time making it from scratch too, y'all. I'm excited about that. But yeah, I had a nice time. It was an installation of Miss Dorothy Brown on this evening. And I was kind of doubting myself. I'm a minister. I don't share that too much with you guys, but I'm a minister over there at Temple of Destiny Church. It's at 4589 Martin Luther King in St. Louis, Missouri, where the pastor is newly installed Bishop Devon A. Caruso. And I'm a minister over there. I haven't ministered as far as on the mic or anything in a while. We're going to keep these bad boys on standby. But I minister every day to my family and my friends. And just ask the Lord lead me. Uh-oh, I could have turned that fire off. And we're going to bring that rapeseed oil over here. We're going to go ahead and coat this pan with this.
If I can get the thing open. Like this is going around and around. Oh boy. Okay. Ooh, I didn't know it was gonna be this hard for this cap to come off. There we go. Maybe I was making it hard. I wanna see how it would smell. It's like it don't have no smell. Probably be a nice clean oil. 100% grapeseed oil. It certainly should be light. That's for sure. We're gonna get a nice sear on these chicken breasts. A lot of stuff over here. I'll probably measure out, because we're going to have to use half and half. I'm going to measure that out. Let's see. Have this over here on standby. See, we're gonna put these same seasonings over into that these pasta, because you gotta, if you season your meat, you gotta season your pasta. So we're gonna be doing that. If we're gonna add, we're gonna sear this chicken, then we're gonna grill our vegetables and stuff. It's so small over here. Okay. Yeah, we're gonna move this party over there. Party over here. This is gonna go pretty fast. Once everything gets to working. So yeah, Dorothy, I want to get her name right. Let me see. I think I said Dorothy. Did I say Dorothy Brown? I think her name was Dorothy Brown. She got a newly installed pastor at her church. I'm not sure of the name of the church. I'm finna measure out three to three and a half cups of half and half. We got a pound of pasta we working with. Yeah, this took about, taking all the half and half I got left. I'm gonna have to get some more. That was perfect. It was waiting on this dish. I'm gonna use three cups of that. Yeah, we just get in that pan. And, I was doubting myself. I said, Lord, I feel like my life is such a mess, you know. When I think about, you know, I'm divorced as of 2019. You know, I didn't get married till I was 43. You know, I had children out of wedlock. I was unsaved, you know, before the age of 26. So I didn't grow up in the church. Nobody in my family, to my knowledge, is a minister or anything like that. My children, they none of them have went to college, and I didn't finish college or whatever. So when I look, you know, it's very dangerous when you get to comparing your life with other people's lives and stuff. But see, we be thinking we off schedule or we're not where we need to be. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this down in here. Get a nice sear. Cook it for about 5 minutes on each side. Yeah. We're gonna see what you gonna be, what you working with, grape seed oil. Cajun chicken Alfredo. Yeah, and you know, so I was kind of, I said, Lord, am I qualified? Should I be doing this and everything? Maybe I heard wrong, you know, and I'm just doubting myself, you know, a little bit. And you know, and I was all like, and I, then I started doing my affirmations on the way to church, you know, trying to encourage myself. Because sometimes you have to encourage yourself. Amen. Sometimes you have to encourage yourself, you know. Sometimes you're not gonna have a big rah-rah team and a whole bunch of people behind you cheering you on. Sometimes you gotta encourage yourself, man. And so I, you know, because I've been listening to Stormy Wellington too as well, and she is a multi-million dollar coach. And she has products that she has. I think she does some multi-level marketing, and she has people that she coached to success, and they become seven-figure earners as well. And she has these affirmations. She's all into energy. She's all into positive affirmations and getting your mind right and making sure that your circle is right, because you're as good as the people that you're around. Look at that. Getting that blackened. And I might turn it over, cook it some more. That looks good though. Ooh-wee. Yeah, you know, so I began to say, you know, both Bible affirmations and just decreeing and declaring what I am and what I want, you know, out of my life and who God says I am. You know, I'm above and not beneath. I'm the head and not the tail. I will never be broke a day in my life. That's one of hers. I will never be broke a day in my life. I have favor on today. I mean, I kept on saying I got favor with man. I got favor with you, Lord. And I just began to decree and declare that thing as far as favor and as far as, you know, letting myself know. I don't know if I say I'm enough, but a lot of times during my affirmation, I say I am enough. I am more than enough, you know. I am more than enough. You have to, you know, speak over yourself and don't allow just anybody and everybody to speak over you. Don't allow anybody and everybody to just speak over you and just say what they want to say. Speaking, you know, because words are spells. Words are spells. We have no idea how powerful words are. They are so powerful. It smells so good, y'all. I can't wait to turn into this, boy. I already know. It smells fantastic. I want to bring the camera over here so you guys can have a better look at it. This long wire on here. Look at that. That's going to be blackened chicken breast, Asian chicken breast that we're working right there. We got our white wine vinegar on standby. We got our seasonings. We got our half and half. See, that wasn't nothing but the enemy trying to make me doubt myself and all of that, you know. And ironically, I ran into Sister Elsie, one of my prayer partners from back in the day, her niece. And she was at the church last Sunday, and I didn't even realize that was her. Kim Carter. I ran into her. And she had a grandbaby with her. I forgot the little baby name. She's a beautiful little baby girl. It was good to see her. A familiar face. It's always good to see a familiar face. My daughter was at work, so thank God, you know, she's back at work. When I say this chicken smells so good, we're going to have it resting on the side, and we're going to cut it up in bite-sized pieces. And we're going to put it in there the last minute after we have the sauce and everything working. We're going to cook all the veggies and stuff right in this mixture right here, because that's going to give it flavor right there. I should have gave y'all a salad of drained noodles. This is going to be amazing. And so we, you know, my pastor, you know, wanted us all to go over there for the, I didn't know it was an installation service, but he wasn't going to stay for the whole service. He, you know, needed to go to dinner, you know, because everybody, he had already preached and everything over there at his church and stuff, you know, just wanted to support her. And, you know, and say hello and support her for part of the service and everything. But I was just led to stay to the end of the service. Because I don't know, I just knew that God had a word for me. I just knew he was going to speak to me some kind of way. I didn't know how he was going to speak to me. But it was very interesting that the lady that was being, you know, because her husband was a bishop. I forgot what his name was. I want to say Brown. Her name is Dorothy Brown. I want to say Brown. And her husband had died, and the Lord, I guess, started tugging on her. They could see that she said when she gave her testimony, people was, people like, well, I don't know those other, I don't know if they were pastors or if they were ministers or whatever, but I know Bishop Iona Dixon, she was there, and she kept it real. And you know, and I love the way she said to be a lady, be who God made you. You don't have to try to be like a man. You know, you don't have to be like a man. Be a lady. She said her, I think she said her father told her that. Or was it her pastor or something? So somebody, some male told her that to be a lady, don't try to be, you know, be like a man. Be what God made you, you know. Be what God made you. And she's just very encouraging. And then it was another lady that spoke to her. And then, and her niece sung a beautiful song that was very encouraging. What was that? I mean, it spoke to my soul. The name of that song, I think if you can make it, I think if you can make it, or they said if you wouldn't make it, or something like that. You know, it just speaking to my soul, wasn't nobody but God. It wasn't nobody but God to me. From the song choices and everything, you know, wasn't nobody but God ministering to me through song, through those encouraging testimonies and stuff. You know, them being in ministry, you know, nothing but a Holy Ghost setup. It was meant for me to be there. And when I say those people were so kind and nice and welcoming, usually I've been having to catch the bus home, you know. I stayed for the whole service. It was like about 6 o'clock. It don't get dark till 8 o'clock, so that's good. And I began to, I just sat there in the vestibule, and, you know, they were asking me did I would need some water, and did I, did I want anything, you know, and I asked them, did they have any snacks? They gave me some chips and a little tiny, moon pie. I thought that was so sweet. I mean, just very accommodating. I met the pastor. I met Austin Lane. He was telling me about how they started the district as far as, I think, the Midwest district. And it was just very interesting. I met the pastor of the church, you know, the usher named Miss Era. She come to find out that wasn't nothing but the Holy Ghost set up. She one of the people that greeted me at the door. She, you know, I was asking her, did she know of anybody that could take me to a bus stop, you know? And she said, well, where do you stay at? And I said, you see it? She said, I do too. Now, you know that ain't nobody but God. What's the odds of that? I've never been to that church, as far as I know, in my life. I've never been to that church. When I say never been to that church, I've never been to that church. And then, you know, because my pastor was asking me whether I'm going to be okay, but I'm just led to just stay there. I'm just led to stay there, but God worked it out. Because I believe those affirmations and those declarations, you know, unto God, and decreeing and declaring that thing out loud like that, manifested that blessing of, you know, those ladies. This is a Suffragan bishop. Iona is a Suffragan bishop. She's high in the faith. You know, I forgot the name of her church. Ooh, it's on the tip of my tongue, the name of her church. I haven't seen her in years either. I want to taste a little piece of this. I want to sneak and taste a little piece. I'm going to turn this fire down some. Some of this stuff kind of dark. I don't want to overcook this chicken. Take it on out of there. Let it rest. We'll let it rest for a few minutes before we cut into it. Look at that. Get into it, y'all. Look at that. Blackened chicken, Cajun blackened chicken breast. And we're going to put a little bit more grapeseed oil in here. Turn this camera over here so y'all can see what I'm doing. We're going to put the minced garlic in. I wasn't ready for the get into it. Got onions. Put those in. We're gonna let these kind of get translucent. We're gonna add our other vegetables. Not quite ready for that mushroom just yet. That onions, and I love fresh garlic. I had put a little bit more grapeseed oil in there. Try about a tablespoon. Ooh, that smells amazing. And she ended up taking me all the way home, girl. I mean, honey, she ended up taking me all the way home. That wasn't nobody but a Holy Ghost set up. We exchanged numbers and everything. I might have made me a new friend, like I made a new friend in the Lord. Ain't nothing like being friends with the saints, you know. I mean, just a nice disposition. I felt welcome from the time I came to the door to the time I left up out of there. I really did. Happy Guitar Man, he was there. He was playing some old favorites and everything. Eddie Haynes, I believe that is. He's an elder. Elder Eddie Haynes, Happy Guitar. He's a St. Louis icon here in the music, in the Christian community. Yes. Ooh, this smells good, y'all. Getting too wet. Ooh. put some of this sun-dried tomato in here. I had to put the mushrooms in. Where is this gonna be? Good. But yeah, God is so good. He is too good. Okay, we got the pasta. It's a Paolo Rotini pasta. Gonna take our I'm gonna put some white wine vinegar in here. Stir it around. Uh-oh, sorry, the right wine vinegar in y'all way. Just kind of stirring the noodles around this vinegar, white wine vinegar. I'm gonna put a cup, the other 2 cups. And our seasoning, this is the Creole seasoning. Pepper. Love me some pepper. Sea salt. We're gonna put some of the smoked paprika in it. Smoked paprika. That gives such a beautiful color. We're gonna work this on in, y'all. Just bring this down to a simmer. Stir it in. Put some of that Parmigiano in. Spread that all over. Stir it in. We had a high time in the Holy Ghost. High time in the Holy Ghost. Let me steal me a noodle. Put some more Parmigiano. Ooh, pepper. Cheesy. Woo. I want to try and put another three-fourths cup milk. Just letting that simmer down. Let the cheese really incorporate in there. Kitchen seasoning. Make sure it got that kick in there. Stir that around. Okay, we're gonna cut these up. It's so tender, it's breaking up, y'all. This is delicious. I mean, juicy. Put that camera up close to this. Man, I'm gonna turn this fire off that this is about simmered down. Look at that. Cajun. That is Cajun chicken breast. I'm gonna place that right on top of here. That is the money shot. I'm gonna give y'all. Give y'all a view of it. Look at that. And there you have it. We got Cajun chicken Alfredo with rotini noodles. We got mushrooms and garlic. Delicious. I'm going to plate this. I want y'all to get my reaction. This looks too good, you guys. Can't wait. Can't wait. Can't believe I'm gonna film the taste video right along with this. I'm trying to cut my time down. Noodles now. Oh, you know what? Let me get some parsley on there. I am tripping. Got to put some parsley. Look at that. Oh, I could have put that light on. Oh, that's right. I don't have my, what you call it? Yeah, we're going to end it with some parsley flakes. Give it some color. And then we can top it with some more of the mozzarella. I mean, not mozzarella, but Parmigiano cheese. Yes. There it is, Cajun chicken Alfredo. This is good. Delicious. That is so good. I made it right. So easy, y'all. As always, the ingredients will be in the description box. And got a little crisp on that chicken too. That is good, y'all. No cap, like they say, no cap. That is delicious, A1 and done. I'm telling you, you guys got to try this. Because we'll be eating off of this a few days, man. You can have this for not for breakfast, but you can have this for lunch. You can have this for dinner. Put a salad on the side. I could have did some steamed broccoli, but this is more than enough. This is a meal. This is a meal right here. I mean, just so simple. You can use whatever noodles that you want. You know, actually, I think the Asiago and the Parmesan and Romano kind of brought it out. Those are Italian cheeses. This is an Italian dish, and it's awesome. But they say magnifico. Ooh, I mean, I gotta get me some soda, y'all, and get into this how I want to. Y'all can make some y'all can make some garlic bread to go with that. I mean, delicious. Not too much cooking, because you can have as little or as much of heat as you want in the dish. It's got a little heat to it, Cajun. Thanks to this Tony's Chatteries Creole seasoning. And that smoked paprika. I'm loving that. As always, like, share, and subscribe. Support this channel by Cash Apping me, $ Crystal Thomas 47 or Zell Crystal Wagner 37 at yahoo.com. And as always, thank you for watching and be blessed. Cooking with Chrissy and the Lou. Till next time. Ciao.